We have the Victron Orion XS, the Orion XS 1400, as well as the Redarc BCDC Alpha100 R in our store, shop.EXPLORIST.life. Now, from our perspective, they're both great units, but ultimately you have to make a decision on what type of DC to DC charger you want in your rig. In this video, we're going to compare and contrast these two units. That way you can make an informed decision on what's best for your particular build. Now, what are both of these units at their core? Because they both serve realistically pretty much the same function. Both of these units are going to charge a house battery bank or auxiliary battery bank from your engine's alternator. So they both do that, and they both do it very well, but they both have some pretty big differences in sort of how they do that. Now, first and foremost, you're going to notice that the Orion XS, as well as the Orion XS 1400, is significantly smaller than the Redarc counterpart. Now, we'll get to sort of why, you know, coming right up, but ultimately, this is a 50 amp output unit, or about 700 watts of charging power. It's a 12 volt to 12 volt version. Now, the Orion XS 1400 is almost the exact same form factor, but it's a 24 volt version. So it's going to be 700 watts or so if you have a 12 volt house battery bank or if you have a 12 volt alternator. Now, if you have a 24 volt alternator and a 24 volt house battery bank, you can get up to 1400 watts out of a Orion XS 1400, which is almost the same unit, except it has a little bigger heat sink on the back of it. Now, that's sort of why this particular unit right off the bat is, you know, a little less than half the size of the Redarc BCDC Alpha100 R, is because it's simply puts out less amps. The BCDC Alpha100 R here, like its name says, it's going to put out 100 amps. So realistically, this is the same thing to a degree as two of these. And so you can kind of see, if you stack two right here side by side, you're getting pretty close to the physical size of the two of them. As far as, like, you know, widths and stuff like that, they're pretty similar, you know, a couple millimeters or fractions of an inch off, but realistically they're pretty similar in terms of like how thick they are. Now, when it comes to size, if the actual amperage output and charging speed is important to you, it's also important to consider that if you have two of these, although it seems like they're going to be the same footprint, keep in mind all of the wiring that you have to use to wire this together. The wiring kit that we supply for a dual Victron Orion XS setup takes up, you know, realistically about the same amount of footprint as another one of these. So realistically, by the time it's all said and done with, this is actually going to have a smaller footprint than two of these because of all of the, honestly, excessive wiring that two of these takes to wire up. So if we're trying to pick winners here on different features, you know, this is definitely going to win if faster charging is a high priority for you. So, you know, that's realistically the case. If you have, you know, if you don't need to charge quite as fast and you're more interested in a smaller footprint, obviously this one is going to fit the bill much better. Next up, let's talk about communications of this device versus this device here. If you have a full Victron system, you already know that Victron has excellent communications between all of their components through either the Victron Connect app or more popularly, the Servo GX or eChrono GX for a nice touchscreen display. eChrono GX for a nice touchscreen display. So the Orion XS or the Orion XS 1400, either unit is going to communicate with the Victron Connect app, just the same as all your other Victron gear in your system, as well as it's going to connect through this VE Direct port down here on the bottom to the eChrono GX or the Servo GX. So you can see its specific charging efforts right on that touchscreen or right in the app. Now, the Redarc component, it will not communicate with the Victron Connect app. It has its own app, so you can see a lot of the same information as this, but if you have the Redarc BCDC Alpha100R, in a system with a bunch of Victron components, it's still going to work wonderfully. And I actually really recommend that in quite a few applications, but you just have to understand that you're not going to be able to see the charging efforts of this specific device within the Victron Connect app. Now, do you lose all, you know, do you have to use two apps to sort of monitor charging efforts? And no, you don't, because if you have this device in a overall Victron system with a Victron Smart Shunt, a Victron BMV 712, a Victron Link Shunt, any kind of Victron-based shunt, you're still gonna see the charging efforts of this BCDC charger here through the shunt. Because if a device is using a little bit of power, but this device is charging the batteries, you're still going to see that information realized, you know, going through the shunt. So in my perspective, and whenever I use a system, I'm rarely actually, like, you know, clicking into this device and seeing what this device is contributing on a sole device perspective. And I'm just going into my shunt, and then I'm going to see, hey, the batteries are charging it 30 amps, regardless of where it's coming from, regardless of if it's here or solar or shore, it doesn't really matter to me. And I think you have the same sort of features, functionality set in that similar regard if you're using something like this Redarc component. And, you know, it's still gonna work just fine, you know, within a Victron ecosystem system. So if Victron communications specifically is, you know, the most important thing to you, you want all of your components talking to each other through an app, through the centralized touchscreen, you know, the Victron is going to be a better choice here. Now, if you just want to have a general overview of all charging efforts, then the Redarc device is going to, you know, sort of fit the bill just fine in that regard. Hey, just a heads up, all of this stuff that you're finding on this video, as well as this whole channel, is available in our store, shop.explorist.life. This entire channel at this point in time is funded entirely by purchases coming from our store. So if you're benefiting from this video, if you're enjoying the tutorials, if you're learning something new, consider purchasing from shop.explorist.life so that we can keep making these videos. We're priced the same as anywhere else you'll find online, including Amazon, and all of those proceeds go back to funding these videos. So thanks for watching. Back to the video. And a short comparison that I sort of touched on earlier, the Victron Orion XS is available in a 24 volt version as well. So like I mentioned earlier, Victron Orion XS 12-1250 here. There is a Victron Orion XS it's a dual voltage unit. It's got 12 volt or 24 volt input, as well as 12 volt or 24 volt output. And you can kind of configure that depending on if you have a 12 or 24 volt house battery bank or alternator. So that is something that sort of sets it apart from the Redarc unit here. This is only available at the time of shooting this video, available in a 12 volt to 12 volt version. Now on the flip side, let's talk about solar charging, because this device here has solar charging built into it. It's somewhat limited because it has only a 48 volt input maximum, which sort of limits you to, like, realistically about, you know, let's call it 500 to 600 watts of charging, which, you know, may not seem like that much when we're talking about the bigger Victron solar charge controllers, you know, a big MPPT, you know, 250, 100 or something like that, that can charge a 12 volt battery bank, you know, 1450 watts. Because of that higher voltage, we can still use 10 gauge wire with it, but I digress. This has solar built into it, and it has a 48 volt input maximum, and it can output 110 amps of solar, which theoretically and on paper means that you can attach up to 2000 watts of solar to it. But to do that with a 48 volt max, you'd realistically have to use excessively large wire to go from the solar panels to this unit, and I can't really make that recommendation. So that's the on paper actual max that it can handle, but the real world sort of what I can recommend with using 10 gauge PV wire that's appropriate for solar panels, you know, is in the, like, let's call it like 500 to 700 watt range. You know, on the contrary, this doesn't have any solar charging at all. Victron breaks all of their components out to where, you know, each unit sort of has one job. And the job of this unit is to charge from the alternator, and it has no solar in it at all. Now, on the other side of this, talking about solar, this has a cool feature that if, say, you're driving down the road during the daytime, and you've got 700 watts of solar panels up top, and you're also driving, so your alternator is also turning and trying to charge the house battery bank, this is actually going to prioritize solar charging. So it's going to take those 700 watts of solar charging, and it's going to go ahead and put that out. And then it's going to, you know, do the calculations and analytics, and it's going to take the remaining power that it can put out, and it's going to pull that from the alternator. So it's going to work the alternator, you know, a little bit less. You know, you may get, you know, 0.001 miles per gallon better or something like that, you know, on paper or whatever the case is. But realistically, this is going to prioritize solar over alternator, which is kind of a cool feature. Now, the other part about that is if you are not driving and you leave your headlights on and you drain your starter battery, or you're draining your starter battery, this is going to use solar to charge the auxiliary battery bank, just like a regular solar charge controller. But since this is connected to your starter battery, it's going to take the power from the solar panels. And then once the house battery bank is charged, this is going to use solar to charge the starter battery in sort of a reverse function, which is something everybody has been asking me, you know, a solution for. And this doesn't offer that. You know, in the same regard, this doesn't offer any kind of like reverse alternator charging, if you will, from the house battery bank to the starter battery. So this can't charge the starter battery. This can. This can take that solar, go backwards, but you can also, like if it was at night, there was no solar production, you left your lights on in your RV or motorhome, and your starter battery is dead, but your house battery bank is, you know, full or nearly full or even half full, it doesn't really matter. You can get onto the Redarc app and hit a button, and this is going to fast charge your starter battery for about 15 minutes from the house battery bank. And it's not like a jump start necessarily, but it's going to pump a little bit of power into that starter battery, so, you know, not till it gets to full. It's not made to be like a, you know, full-time charger, but it's going to get your starter battery up to the point where, you know, you can then start your engine and then your alternator can recharge that starter battery. So I think that's another great feature that a lot of people have been asking us about for quite a while, and this is sort of the answer to that. So if solar is important, and you want solar in the same thing, you want solar to be able to charge your starter battery, and you want a little bit of a fail-safe to charge your starter battery from your house battery bank, this wins all day because ultimately this doesn't even have that functionality. So it is what it is. I still think this is a great unit in that regard, but it's just limited in its capabilities for that. So let's talk about pricing. Now, I don't really like comparing just a component to another component because ultimately, if you compare the price of this component to the price of this component, this is way less expensive because, as we talked about, you know, it's half as powerful. It doesn't have solar. It doesn't have that reverse charging capabilities. So we're going to talk about, you know, I'll let you know what the price of it is, but I also want to do a more apples to apples comparison that's going to take the price of the Redarc 100 amp charger plus its wiring kit, which I think wiring kit pricing is also important because what good's a component without a wiring kit? And if the wiring kit's really, really expensive, well, you guys should know that too. I'm also going to say, you know, what if we do two of these to sort of get the same, you know, capabilities from a charging standpoint, plus the wiring kit that's necessary for this, or two of these. So Grace and I pulled the numbers. We made some carts on shop.explorers.life where we have both of these. If you would like to purchase either one of them, the Redarc BCDC Alpha100 R DC battery manager, it comes out to just shy of $1,600 at $1,599. The Victron Orion XS 50 amp charger comes out to $328.10. So if you wanted two of these units, you know, that's going to be $656.20. So, you know, ballpark of, you know, a little less than half of the cost of this one. So what about wiring kits? The wiring kit for the Redarc is going to be in a 25-foot version, so it's going to be good for you guys with like camper vans specifically. 25-foot version comes out to $259.99, and that's all the wiring to go all the way from your starter battery to this unit, and then from this unit to your Lynx distributor or whatever distribution system that you're using in your build. So if you wanted this component, the wiring kit for this in a 25-foot version, you're looking at $1,858.99. And if you wanted it in a 50-foot version, for those of you with like tow-behind campers, motorhomes, anything that's a little larger, need a longer wire run, that wiring kit, because it uses pretty big wire, is $509.99. And that totals out to this plus the 50-foot wiring kit is $2,108.99. Now, shifting gears just a little bit and talking about this device. If we were doing two of these plus the dual Orion XS wiring kit, the dual Victron Orion XS wiring kit in a 40-foot version, so it's not exactly apples to apples, but we're honestly trying to get rid of the dual Orion XS wiring kit because it's realistically a pain to make on our side as well as a pain to install on y'all's side. So the price of that kit is $439.99. So it's, you know, kind of halfway in between the two wiring kit prices. So if you wanted two of these plus the wiring kit 40 feet, you're looking at $1,096.19. So if DC to DC charging was the most important thing to you and you didn't really care about starter battery charging from the house batteries or solar, you know, realistically, this is going to suit your needs just fine at a lower price point. Now, I will say, I've briefly mentioned the wiring kit. This wiring kit for dual Orions, we've shown it on the channel a couple times in the past, and it's honestly a pain in the butt. So just be prepared for that. The wiring kit takes about three times as long to install on two of these as it does for something like this. So, you know, if you're trying to come out with a, you know, your time is valuable, this is going to take you about a third of the time to wire up than it will something like this. So consider that. Now, to make this as apples to apples as we possibly can, considering this is a 100 amp DC to DC charger, and we would need two of these plus the associated wiring kits plus this has solar charging available in it. I made another cart that had two of the Orion XS 12-1250 DC to DC chargers, the dual Victron Orion wiring kit, a Victron Smart Solar MPPT 150 solar charge controller, and its associated wiring kit. And that all totals out to $1,347.63. So realistically, you know, apples to apples comparison, as close as we can get, considering the features that, you know, this just can't have, like the reverse charging to the starter battery, this is a less expensive option. So realistically, I think that sort of kind of wraps it up. Does it? Is that true? And here is sort of an overview of those prices, depending on if you're wanting, you know, single Orion XS or single Redarc BCDC or dual units or whatever the case is. Ultimately, here's sort of the pricing breakdown of what that ends up being. So to summarize it, if low cost is what you're looking at, this is what you're after. If you're looking for some solar charging in addition to your DC to DC chargers, this is what you're looking for. If you're looking for ultimate Victron communications, the Victron device is what you're after. And if you're wanting reverse starter battery charging, this is what you're after. Now, if you're wanting a high quality component, honestly, both of these are gonna fit the bill because, you know, Victron has been around for 50 years in the marine industry, and Redarc has been around for 40 plus years in like the trucking industry. And so they've both time tested high quality components, and we sell both of them in our store. So, you know, feel free to browse the store, shop.explorist.life, if you're in the market for a DC to DC charger solution. And if you need some insight or some help, you know, figuring out which one is good for your needs, or maybe more importantly, how to integrate it into your overall system design plans, you know, reach out. We've got full tech support team that's happy to help. shop.explorist.life/support, and we can get you pointed in the right direction. So I hope this comparison was helpful. In the next video, we're going to talk about how to wire one of these right here, because we do have a wiring kit and it's brand new to the store. So we'll see you over there.